and it's stiff, the ruby lens comes on this attachment. And this ruby lens has a holder. I have to make sure this place is facing me because I use this to adjust my hands. So this must face the examiner yourself. So it comes that way. For you to sit here, I have to move it to any direction. It goes in here so I can move sour sour.
Yes. That's
the only way I can use this. If I don't have a plate, I can't use this ruby lens. So you should know that each time you come on this little lamp, you might not see this. You have to look for it, mount it, then put your ruby lens. Okay. People, we are not here. Aiwa? Right, you guys go back. You saw me now. Can this group come, please? 1 minute.
Yeah.
Okay, we are saying this is the ruby lens. You saw it, sir. Huh? And the ruby lens is mounted on a plate. In most of the slit lamps, this might not be here. You can see a slit lamp just like this. The hole here is used for several purposes. For this ruby lens, it comes with a plate, which we mount here and make it stable. Then this ruby lens has a groove here that moves here. Yeah, it moves here. So you can move in and out. So what I do is I mount it on this holder and I move it to this hole. Then I can move with this equipment anywhere I go. That's how it works. So it's easy to manipulate. Now, it's important to know that the ruby lens has a front and a back surface. If I mount this like this on this patient, this hand is not supposed to face him. So it must always face the examiner to you because you are the one manipulating it, sir. So I have to mount it that way.
The planner,
sir. Exactly. So I can use this to adjust on which eye I want to see, which part of the eye I want to rotate this lens, I want to see the nasal part, the temporal part, I change direction myself. So that's the aim of this handle. So you can use it to change direction of where you want to see the fundus. So that's the way it's mounted. It's easy, and you can use it on your own. Okay, so we start with this patient after the grand group coming.
We must use drops.
Eye drops, Plasm, yes. So the pupil can dilate. For the patient, sir?
Yeah.
Yes, you must use drops. Okay, would you put your chin here?
First, I'll sew it up.
Sorry, I'll remove this from the eye because I want to adjust it.
Yes. Why use this lens?
This lens? Because it's a ruby lens.
روبي عشان تقلل هي قوة العين 60 وهي تسوي سالب.
Hold on, he has a good question. If I remove this, I can use the slit lamp on my own just to see the cornea up until the anterior vitreous.
You want to see the inside of eye?
If I want to see the fundus, the retina, and the posterior vitreous, I must use an additional lens. Maybe a ruby lens, maybe a condensing lens, maybe a gonio lens. Either which one. So I have to use an extra device. And what is the aim of that device? That device is to neutralize the power of the eye. The eye is plus 60 diopters. This is minus 60 diopters. If I put minus 60 and plus 60, I get zero. So every refracting surface of the eye is neutralized. So there's no light refraction again. That's what it does. So the light can go straight into the fundus.